Of course we're insignificant on the physical scale. We're less than dust.
Penguin tariffs? In-person meeting.
The Dow surged 300 points last Friday after dropping 400 points that morning.
Did anyone get the doc?
Oh, it's on Slack if you need it.
I also put a link in Airtable, but I can drop it in the Zoom chat.
Oh, it's looking like the project might be canceled.
So here we're stuck with a universe that makes no common practical sense to us and yet is actually the way things are.
I came to the Griffith Observatory to watch the PST art film on cosmograms, an ultimate collision of art and science across cultures. Cosmograms are artistic symbols of the patterns of the sky and a way to try to make sense of our universe.
What do you think attracts people to trying to make sense of the world that they see?
The more sense you can make, particularly of more complicated things, is presumably an advantage for survival. We're pattern-seeking creatures. We look for patterns because we discern that in some patterns, there is meaning that's useful.
The figures just inside the circle, around its rim, are the 36 decans. Those represent the stars that newly rise at the eastern horizon once every 10 days. 10 days times 36 stars equals a year of 360 days.
The film was conceptualized by the legendary director of the Griffith Observatory, Dr. Ed Krupp.
Art and science are, in fact, two elemental aspects of human activity. They are ways of dealing with ourselves in the world. They are different, but they're in fact intended to do the same thing ultimately, which is to make ourselves feel at home in the cosmos. The sky is a rhythmic theater on which the very principles of time and space are displayed as though they're on stage.
Rhythmic stage?
I was so excited about seeing the stars after this. I couldn't wait until it was dark so I could visit the telescope. Wait, rewind the tapes.
I think our ancient and prehistoric ancestors would imagine that we must be addled because we don't see that sky in our urban environments, that we've lost the sky.
Yes, I know there were clouds in ancient and medieval times too, but also LA has a lot of light pollution. So I decided to go find my own sky.
The Environmental Protection Agency has rolled back dozens of environmental protections today.
Need perfectly sliced bananas? Get the banana slice.
We're talking about antiquity, making sense of the world, making sense of the universe, but then we're also talking about politics and economy, and this is ancient stuff, but this is stuff that we can consider right now.
There's no question that the basic human behavior that's been in place for our entire history and prehistory is still in place.
I'm Jessie.
This is Nick. He owns Three Sons Farm in Julian, California. And after a controversial episode that made me think about lab-grown meat and our growing disconnect from the food we eat, I decided to make a stop to buy some eggs and meat straight from the farm where they were raised.
Hi, babies! Thank you for your eggs!
Julian is an international dark sky community, which means the town is actively committed to reducing light pollution to preserve the night sky. And right down the road in Borrego Springs is the Anza-Borrego Desert State Park, an international dark sky park where I'll be camping the next two nights in search of the stars. I thought about how this season started with the medieval fascination of starlight. And then, like the episode after that, I couldn't help but notice that it felt like I was inside of a real-life diorama. I thought about my visit to the Natural History Museum and wondered if, in fact, this whole season had led me on this journey to reconnect with nature.
I'm so happy.
Ah! Did you see that?
Mm-hmm. You did it.
Oh, that fire is lit, baby.
This sausage is looking so good.
Dinner of champions.
Oh my god, that's so good.
Wow. Did you hear that?
As the clouds rolled in that night, I began to wonder if I would ever see the stars or finish this episode, the last of my PST art-inspired season, when I remembered something Ed had said in our interview.
So I think artists are always in the middle of something that's never quite completed, and they keep on going, and the pleasure is not in the finish line. It's just delightfully entertaining to be in the midst of it now.
Instead of trying to force an ending, I decided to settle into the flow of the journey and check out what the visitor center had to offer. And then something interesting happened.
The term, the new world, it's not new to us. How can you discover a land where people are already residing? When we speak our language, that is resistance, and we do that out of love.
With the Kumeyaay.
Not only did I realize I was back on Kumeyaay lands, where in the Oceans Unseen episode, I got to build traditional Kumeyaay boats and learn some of the language,
Asuk.
But I realized here in Anza Borrego, I was on an unseen ocean from millions of years ago. This whole park used to be an ancient sea.
If we wanted to look for fossils from the ancient oceans, would Fish Creek be the place to go?
You could go to Fish Creek and find many, many shells. We are here, right here at the visitor center, and here is Fish Creek campground right here.
Awesome. Okay, let's do it. Should we make some PB&Js?
Let's do it.
Okay, I'm just gonna say right out that I didn't actually find any fossils at Fish Creek. But I was overwhelmed with just how stunning it was. Then that night, there were still some clouds. But like Ed had said, it was delightfully entertaining just to be in the midst of it.
We're watching for stars, but here are the clouds. That's okay, 'cause I'm happy.
I woke up in the middle of the night from a wild amount of wind. It was around 3 a.m. that I felt like I understood why we've characterized natural elements like wind as creature-like gods. It was as if the wind itself was a living being, terrorizing the outside of the tent. And then I thought, maybe if there was a lot of wind, maybe the clouds had been swept away. Maybe I could see the stars in all their glory. It was worth a try.
Okay. Ladder. You can see the entire Milky Way. Oh my god.
Of course we're insignificant on that scale, but we get to be part of that whole thing. And what we do is as much a part of the cosmos as every single atom, every subatomic particle, every galaxy. We are a vital element of whatever all of this is.